Hi, I would like to show you how I solved my problem of measuring the temperature and the humidity of my wine cellar in the basement of my house. In the wine cellar, there is no Wi-Fi access and the connectivity is very bad. But I've noticed that the LoRa 868 MHz frequency was well received, so I decided to use LoRa protocol for getting real-time temperature and humidity from my wine cellar. So this tutorial explains how to build an end-to-end LoRa network using very cheap components. Let's start with the LoRa gateway. Components needed are Raspberry Pi, micro SD memory, SD memory adapter, power supply for Raspberry, HDMI cable, wireless keyboard, an RFM95W module wired like in the video. To set up the Raspberry Pi, you need to install the image loader. In my case, I'm using a Mac, but there is also software for PC. Follow the video tutorial on how it can be done in quick, easy steps. Once the software is loaded into the Mac, you will need to launch it in order to load the SD memory with the Raspberry Pi image. Insert the micro SD memory card with the SD memory adapter in the Mac. Choose the memory card and write the image. Wait until the image is loaded in the memory, and then remove the SD adapter from the Mac. Plug the micro SD into the Raspberry Pi. Plug also all the cables in the Raspberry Pi as shown in the video. Plug the Raspberry HDMI cable in a TV HDMI input. Plug the Raspberry power supply. The Raspberry will boot. Wait until the Raspberry boot is finished. You will get a login request. The default login and password is PI and Raspberry, all in small letters. After the login, type the command sudo raspi-config. Activate the SSH server. Activate the SPI interface. Configure the Wi-Fi SSID and password. Exit the configurator and shut down the Raspberry. The command for shutdown is sudo shutdown-h now. Connect the wires of the RFM95W to the Raspberry Pi. Follow the schematic diagram. The video shows how it should look like. Power on the Raspberry Pi again. At this point, the Raspberry Pi should be connected to the local Wi-Fi network and visible on your router. Use the IP address of the Raspberry Pi and connect remotely from your Mac using the terminal application. The command to connect to the Raspberry Pi from the terminal is SSH, IP address of the Raspberry Pi, -L, PI, all in small letters. You will also have to answer yes and insert the Raspberry Pi password, which by default is Raspberry. Install Git on Raspberry. Install the gateway software on Raspberry. Reboot Raspberry. To reboot the Raspberry, you need to use the shutdown command but with the -r option. With a reboot, you will be disconnected from the Raspberry. After 1 minute, reconnect using the SSH command as you did before. Now you need to install the wiringpi application. Enter in the gateway directory to modify the main configuration. Edit the main.cpp file and insert the correct IP address for the Things network server. Type make to compile the gateway application. Now you can run the gateway server on the Raspberry. Use the command shown on the video. If you do not see any errors, the gateway is ready. You need now to add the gateway on the Things Network website. I have already an account. If you don't have it, it's free and easy to set up. Once you logged in, you need to select the gateway section. For easier configuration, keep the terminal gateway window open on a side. Select Register Gateway and start inserting the data that is in the terminal, as you see on the video. It's important that the gateway ID is copied into the registration page. Description and other fields need to be inserted as well. After the configuration is done, you will see the new gateway listed in the console page. To check that the gateway is working, launch the gateway server on the Raspberry terminal, select the gateway on the Things Network console, and check the last seen value. If the value gets updated to zero regularly, then all is working fine. Now let's set up the Arduino temperature and humidity device. The components I used are Arduino Nano, RFM95W module, 868MHz antenna, I2C OLED display, DHT22 temperature and humidity sensor. Now connect all the components to the Arduino Nano following the schematic diagram in the video. The diagram will also be available to whoever is interested. Once the components are all connected, go back to the Things Network website and register the device. After you log in, select Applications. Select Add Application. Create an application ID in small letters, write a description, and then press Add Application. Go to the Devices section, and select Register Device. Create a device ID in small letters, select to auto-generate the device and the app keys, and then press Register. In the Device Overview, select Settings. Select ABP in the activation method and press Save. At this point, you have all the data you need to insert into your Arduino sketch, such as device address, network session key, and app session key. These values will need to be copied and pasted into the sample sketch that I will send you. Now load the sketch in the Arduino and switch it on. Be sure that also the gateway is switched on and running. If the device is up and running, go back to the Things Network website and check if the data from the device is arriving to the server. You will notice that the data is arriving in hex format. This is not handy, so we need to convert it. Go to the Applications, Data, Payload Formats and enter the code that I will send you by email. The code will convert the data arrived in hex format, in decimal temperature and humidity readable format. In case you do not see data arriving, go back to the device overview and reset the frame counters. This could help you get back the data. If you enjoyed my video, put a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.